Hi, this is Raphael, the creator of Cobalt Strike. Welcome to part 4 of the Penetration Testing with Cobalt Strike series. This is the lecture on social engineering. In the last lecture, I took you through most of the client-side attack process. We saw how to profile a system. We talked about testing out different kinds of attacks. And I even showed you how to stage different types of attacks using features such as Office macros, PDF documents, and the like. In this lecture, we're going to talk about how to dress up a browser exploit, and we're going to talk about how to deliver an attack using spear phishing. Here's the overview of this lecture. I'm going to cover Cobalt Strike's website cloning tool. We'll talk about spear phishing. And I know some clients aren't claiming they're ready for social engineering yet. So we'll talk about how you can social engineer your client into letting you work this way. Here's where we're at in the Cobalt Strike process. We're on client-side attack again. This is because client-side attack is extremely important in emulating today's modern threat. It gets two lectures instead of one. Let's start out with the website clone tool. The website clone tool does what it says. It downloads a website, it clones it, puts it up on our local server, and does some magic to fix the images and links. That's it. One use of the website clone tool is to use a JavaScript keylogger to capture user credentials and other information as they interact with our cloned website. If we create a clone of a site that a user interacts with in the course of their work and fool them into clicking it, we might actually be able to get something really valuable. Let's have a look at the clone site feature. Here I am in Cobalt Strike. To clone a website, I go to Attacks, Web Drive-By, Clone Site. Here, I will put in the URL of the website I want to clone. In this case, I've set up a round cube webmail site. Clone that as /roundcube/. And to capture anything that a user enters, I'm just going to check this box, log keystrokes on clone site. Okay, press clone, and there we go. We now have a cloned website to direct somebody to. Next thing I'm going to do to observe the keystrokes, I'm going to go to View, Weblog, and from this window, I'll be able to see anybody that visits our clone site and what they typed. Okay, here I am on a victim system. Let's pretend we got a user to come to our link somehow, okay? Maybe through spear phishing. Let's go ahead and take a look at this site. Here you can see we're at 192.168.12.179. This is my clone site. And I'm going to type in my credentials and press login. And you notice everything worked as you'd expect, in fact. And here I am at the real website now, 192.168.12.178. Okay, let's have a look at this from the attacker's perspective. Here I am in the weblog, and you'll notice here's the keystrokes as they were typed, okay, made available to me. And if I had used a spear phishing attack, this undefined part would probably be populated with the email address of who clicked, because Cobalt Strike is able to keep track of who clicks different links in the spear phishing emails. But here in the weblog, we see the original request to get our clone website. And like I said, there's the keystrokes. So that's the website clone tool with the JavaScript keylogger in action. Another use of the website clone tool is to create a fake website and add an attack to it. Let's take a look at that process. Here we are in Cobalt Strike. First, let's start a client-side attack that we may embed into our cloned website. To do this, I'm going to go to Attacks, Web Drive-By, Signed Applet Attack. This is an old classic favorite. We're going to clone the LinkedIn.com website, so let's give the applet name LinkedIn Chat, make the publisher LinkedIn, and let's give it a cool URI like /inchat. And because this is a Metasploit framework exploit that we're starting, it has to be on a different port from Cobalt Strike. So we'll run this from port 443. Notice that I'm already going to use the Java interpreter listener over port 21. If you don't see anything here, just click Add. Now we're ready to press Launch. And here we go. The web server is started with our Java signed applet attack. Great. Now let's clone a site. Go to Attacks, Web Drive-By, Clone Site. I'm going to type in the URL for LinkedIn, linkedin.com. Notice that our Cobalt Strike web server is going to bind to port 80. Now to embed an attack, I could just put an arbitrary URL of an attack right here. Okay? But I can also click on this button and I get a list of client-side attacks that are currently running and available to me. All I have to do is highlight one, press choose, and now that client-side attack will be embedded in my cloned website as an iframe. And of course, if I want to, and we already saw this, I can actually log keystrokes as well on the cloned site. I can do that with or without an embedded attack, it doesn't matter. Now let's clone the website. Just press clone. And there we go. LinkedIn is cloned for us. Okay, welcome to our victim system. Let's pretend we sent this person a LinkedIn invitation via spear phishing attack. And let's go ahead and go to that website. You know, the world's largest social network. And of course, it's asking me if I want to run LinkedIn chat by LinkedIn. Of course, let's press run. But you can see this is a pretty convincing looking LinkedIn.com. We've got the fave icon. Looks like LinkedIn to me. And of course, if we come back to the attacker system, you'll notice we have a Meterpreter session waiting for us. Let's go right-click, Meterpreter, Explore, Screenshot. This is Java Meterpreter. And there's our victim system, captured with a nice cloned website. Let's talk about spear phishing. Spear phishing is a pretty simple process. Step one, select a template, import your targets, choose which attack you want to embed or add an attachment, and send. Now, there's a lot of programs that can do this. Writing a Perl script to send email is pretty trivial. And email programs do a pretty good job at sending email. I wouldn't call them spear phishing tools, though. No, the hard part of a good fish is making one that's convincing. So what Cobalt Strike is good at is helping you create message templates. Through Cobalt Strike, you can take an email that you saved from another program, and you can just use it, and Cobalt Strike will rewrite the message and make it into a suitable fish. It's also possible to add tokens to the message to make sure it's customized for each person it's sent to. The nice thing is, if you build up a collection of these, you'll be able to reuse them between engagements, saving you time and making it much easier to have a repeatable process for this part of the penetration testing engagement. Here are the tokens that you can add to your templates. Remember, templates are nothing more than saved email. And these tokens, like I said, are replaced before the message is sent. You can replace the embedded URL if there's somewhere in the message you want to put it in plain text, because Cobalt Strike will actually rewrite all links in an HTML email for you. You can substitute the name of the target when that's imported. And you can also put the person's email address throughout the email as well. Here we are in Cobalt Strike. Let's have a look at this process in action. I'm going to minimize Cobalt Strike, and let's go over to my Gmail account. Here, I have an invitation from LinkedIn. Raphael Mudge has indicated that I'm a friend and would like to add me to his professional network. That's wonderful. Now, to save this message, I'm going to go to this More button, click it, Show Original, and I get back the raw email from LinkedIn. Great. Now all I need to do is press Control A, right click, copy. Now let's go to my desktop, New Text Document. We'll call it LinkedIn Template. Let's open it up, paste in the email. If I want to, I can change the Raphael Mudge, that's fine. But I don't see anything in here referring to the name of my person I'm sending it to. The to field will automatically be replaced by Cobalt Strike. So actually, I'm done. This is a template. I don't need to do anything else to it. So I'm going to press File, Save. We now have an email template suitable for use with Cobalt Strike. Now, let's create a targets file. Again, this will be just a text file. Call it targets. Okay, let's make this to Jim Stevens. His address that we'll use will be student1@acme.com. We'll put a tab in there, Jim Stevens. Great. File, save. We now have a targets file. If I want, we'll send this to multiple people. No problem there. Now, close the file. We now have a template. We now have a target. Let's send a spearfish. Go to Attacks, Spearfish. This is Cobalt Strike's spearfishing dialog. Press this folder to select the targets file. Here you can see how they've been imported. Press this folder to select a template. Here we'll choose our LinkedIn template. I can either attach a file, one of those nifty Word documents or an Excel document or a PDF, or I can embed a URL. Here we are. These are the different sites already set up by Cobalt Strike. You can see RoundCube from earlier in this lecture is available to us, or our clone of LinkedIn.com. Let's try the clone of LinkedIn.com. I'll press Choose. And we now have a URL embedded in here. I've already used this spearfishing dialog before, so it remembered the mail server. And it remembered the address that I control that I want messages to bounce to if something's wrong. Now, very important with spearfishing, we get one shot. If I, as a penetration tester, get my spearfish wrong, my presence is now known. So it's very important to get this right. One thing that helps is to click the preview button and take a close look at the message generated by Cobalt Strike. It'll pick one of the random two people and show the message exactly as it would be sent. Here we can see that the headers have been stripped. We've got the from information. We've got the to Jim Stevens, so customize that correctly. If we scroll down into the HTML part, we can see all this stuff about being added on LinkedIn. We can also see that the links have been replaced with our link that we created, the cloned LinkedIn.com. I think this message looks good to me. I'm going to press Close, and to send the message, I click Send. Our fish is now on its way. And there we go. We have sent our spearfishing attack. Now, let's go take a look at this from the target's perspective. Here we are on a target system, and you'll notice I'm logged into my webmail, and I see a LinkedIn invitation. I'm Jim Stevens. I'm going to click on the message, and you can see the recipient is me. I'm okay with the sender. And you'll notice that this looks like a pretty legitimate LinkedIn invitation. Raphael Mudge has indicated I'm a friend. I can accept the link, view the invitation. Pixel perfect email. Let's go ahead and accept the invitation. You'll notice here I am at the world's largest professional network. That's kind of cool. You know, I can get started. It's free. Registration takes less than 2 minutes. Very good. And what's this? Oh, LinkedIn chat from LinkedIn. Well, yeah, sure, I'll run that application. Why not? And there we are, a cloned LinkedIn page. Now, let's go look at this from the attacker's perspective. Here we are, back in Cobalt Strike. You'll notice we have a session on a Windows host. Let's go take a look at a screenshot and see what we've got. Here we are. We can see our blue player looking at LinkedIn.com. Very cool. This is an example of using Cobalt Strike to set up an attack, clone a site, embed that attack, create a reusable template, and use that template to send a convincing phishing attack over to a target. One last thing I'd like to cover, it's an afterthought, is I'd like to show you the reporting that goes with the social engineering campaigns, okay? Go to View, Weblog. You'll notice that we can see, hey, student1 at acme.com visited us. Cobalt Strike actually sends a token with each email so it can identify who clicked the link, okay? Now, let's take a look at the social engineering report that Cobalt Strike creates. View, reporting, social engineering. Press export, and I'll dump this to the desktop. And there we go. Our report is saved. Okay, here's the social engineering report. As usual, we get the PDF bookmarks. If we zoom out, we can see the different campaigns we've launched, the subject line of the message, where we sent the message, when it was sent, how many people clicked. Nice thing too is on a user-by-user basis, we get back all this information such as which website they visited and what it did. We also get back all the captured data and all the unknown visitors, people who that clicked things that we created websites for but weren't associated with a spear phishing attack. So this is an example of Cobalt Strike's social engineering report. Now, let's talk about social engineering the client, if you will. Some clients will say, we're not ready for social engineering attacks. That's a shame. In these situations, you should either be put inside the network assuming you're going to get in through a social engineering attack, or they should let you do something a little bit lighter. This is necessary because this is how bad guys are getting into networks. Bad guys don't care that the people haven't been trained yet. If an organization is not doing what they're supposed to, that's what a pen test is supposed to reveal, is how much that would really hurt. So here are a few options, a few variations on a typical full-scope social engineering engagement that may ease some of your clients' fears. Some clients don't want social engineering engagements because they don't want us to potentially crash the systems of their employees while they're working. In these cases, a Java-signed applet attack is good. It requires a user action, but it's not an exploit. It won't crash the host. Another option, the safest option, is to use the system profiler. Send a spear phishing email out with the system profiler as the embedded link. The system profiler will analyze the attack surface. It'll figure out what the vulnerabilities are. You'll still get a usable report, but you don't have to exploit anything, and there's nothing you'll do to actually hurt the user while they're working. So these are just a couple of variations that may help address concerns that your client may have. In this lecture, we talked about how to dress up attacks using Cobalt Strike's website clone tool. We talked about spear phishing. I also showed you Cobalt Strike's spear phishing reporting capability. And we also talked about how to social engineer the client by talking about a few variations on a normal full-scope social engineering attack. This concludes Lecture 4 of Penetration Testing with Cobalt Strike.